Thanks a lot for the video.
Oh, my pleasure.
All right, so if you want, you send me an email with a title description that you like. I use your title description and links and everything and contact for publishing the video if you want. Otherwise, I'll write to you.
Cool.
Good luck with beating these guys.
Thank you.
I think it's Phoenix, right?
Yes.
Phoenix, yeah, real time. We'll see.
Okay.
Okay, good luck. You need to have something like a tire more affordable. That'd be nice. I can't pay $5,000 per month.
No, but other people can.
But maybe you have like a...
It's something we've thought about.
Different product for...
It's something we've thought about. But there are good companies out there who do it already.
But you know if there's a company doing the thing that I need where I can get my YouTube viewers to kind of like ride the tables and then it connects to the YouTube API and edits it on YouTube?
I don't actually know.
That's something I need. It doesn't exist. Okay.
All right, cool.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
It's the free market.
All right, so we're here at the TechCrunch Disrupt London 2016. AI. Hey, can I make a video? Should you? All right, it's filming here also. Okay, let's do it. I'll ask you a good question. Yeah. Oh, let me give you my card. Right.
Do you have a vlog?
Yeah. Okay, let's do a call.
Okay.
So we're here at the TechCrunch Disrupt here with Air Wander. And who are you?
My name is Ella. I'm founder of Air Wander.
So it says here, travel more, pay less.
Yes.
Flight combination engine. So
yes.
You combine different companies or what do you?
We combine flights.
So how does that work? So you hook up to the full database. What's it called? The one that Google bought. Is that the one that has all the flights and prices?
And we have our own partnerships. So
to get the database on every airline.
Yeah, we have our own database too. So where would you like to go?
I'd like to go to Seychelles. With a, there's a Y here. Y. S E Y.
Ah, okay.
This one, top one there.
Top one.
Yes.
All right. any particular day?
I want to go tonight, tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Yeah.
All right, that's going to be expensive.
Okay.
Let's do it. So, this is kind of our biggest point. Between London and Seychelles.
Nice, so you can go through Paris, it's cheaper?
Exactly.
Really?
It shows you the price difference.
So what's the price?
The estimated price.
So it's 632 from London? And it would be cheaper if you go through Paris?
Exactly, yeah.
So how do I get to Paris? Is that included in this price?
Yes. So now you go, right? You can decide on number of days.
Ah, you get a stopover somewhere.
You get a stopover, that's exactly what it is. Those are the list of the places you can stop on the way. You can decide on number of days. There's no limit to the number of days. You can stay, for example, 6 days somewhere. Also, like those predictions are unique for every flight. So it changes, depends on your origin, destination, and the number of days.
This is what? The number of days you want to spend there?
You want to spend a stopover.
Ah, on the stopover,
in one of
yes.
those cities.
So, all right. What if you go down to one? What happens?
If you go down to one...
And the prices update automatically?
Yeah, they update automatically. I guess for this, there's no update. There's the same price.
So what happens in Paris? What is the exact combination that you need to do?
So now Air Wander combines the flights for you. It looks for two one-way flights and multi-city flights. And whatever will be cheapest is going to be displayed as your top result. And
that's exactly what I needed to do last time. I had to go, and it was cheaper to go through, I had to go in another country.
Yeah.
But you do it automatically.
We do it automatically. That's exactly what we did, because we were going through that pain ourselves, and combining flights manually just is so time-consuming. But yeah, we did the process.
So you can go Vueling and Turkish Airlines. Turkish Airlines is the cheapest right now for some reason. Because
so
they have issues.
Select.
Oh, select, yeah.
But then you went back.
I went back. I want to try something else.
Okay.
Let's try.
Maybe you want to check anywhere and see what other.
You can do anywhere?
You can do anywhere. And that's going to show you the cheapest places going from London. Let's see what
it's going to have. But for $21 you can go to Italy.
Yes.
But it's not a return, is it?
No, this is just one way.
One way, that would be a little bit crazy.
Yeah, and you can go to France, all those are places you can go from UK and the prices.
And you can go round trip?
Yes, you can go round trip, but those are the predictions only for one way.
Ah, okay.
We just launched, so we don't have the predictions for round trips yet.
So you just launched?
We launched yesterday, we were part of the startup battlefield.
Are you qualified for winning the whole thing?
No, we just made it to the finals.
Why?
I don't know.
This is fantastic. This is something everybody needs, right?
Thank you.
How did you how did you engineer this? Where are you based?
We are based in San Francisco, but our team is very international. We have three people in Poland, I'm from Poland, one person in Ukraine, one person in Canada, one person in India, so everybody's from somewhere else. And we work remotely, but our office now is in San Francisco. And it took us 3 years, actually. It's not
3 years?
Yes.
Oh my god.
Previous platform before.
What is the previous? Is it Hipmunk?
No. No.
Is it Momondo?
No.
No? Is it Skyscanner?
No, we would be millionaires if that was Skyscanner, but no. It's it was called Quest Organizer. You probably didn't hear about it. It was kind of small, but we still had a lot of users. So it tested the idea.
What like, was it the name?
The idea
the
was
name was?
Quest Organizer.
Quest Organizer.
Yeah.
Right.
But it wasn't easy on the user. That's why we created Air Wonder. And here are some other cool things you can do with Air Wonder. For example, this is a flight going from San Francisco.
Oh, what's going on there?
Pretty much around the world. So you have three destinations and a stopover between each destination. And that actually reduces your price significantly.
Oh my god, you can go all the way around the world for this price?
Yes, actually it's even better. Like here's from London. This one, it's only £975.
Yeah.
And you go to seven countries across five continents. And you actually cross the Atlantic and the Pacific Ocean. So you literally go around the world.
Yeah.
And yeah, pretty much you can visit all those places for £975.
That's crazy. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 flights, and you go around the world. It's not a return, it's around the world.
It's around the world, it's a return. You start from London and you return from London. And in between you go to Madrid, Marrakesh, this is Barcelona.
Bali.
Los Angeles, Bali, Perth in Australia, and Chennai in India.
That's amazing. Have you used your app yet?
Yes.
Have you gone around the world or you know time?
No, I don't have time to go around the world, sadly. I was planning it this January, but it's not going to happen. But, for example, every time I go from Poland to San Francisco, because I always do that, I always have a stopover. Last time I had a stopover in Reykjavik, so I visited Iceland for 5 days.
I was there
too.
It's so cheap. Where?
Oh, yeah. It was cheap. I combined two flights. I saved $700.
That's £300 or something. This Air.
Yes, it is really cheap and Iceland is really beautiful, so I definitely recommend that as a stopover. Other cool stopovers are Dubai, for example, and Istanbul.
Yeah, let's hope Istanbul is going to stay nice. It's a little bit,
hopefully,
the last 6 months,
dangerous
now it's really cheap. If you want to go cheap, you can go Istanbul.
Yes, you can go to Istanbul.
So something I wonder is, sometimes I check Hipmunk, I check Google Flights, and for some reason Momondo has cheaper, like, what do you call those strange little companies that have cheaper discounts?
Yes.
Do you include those, or what? How low does your price go?
So currently we have partnerships with two OTAs. So later when you book the flight, we just like send you and you can book the flight with them, because we don't take payments. We're only a flight search engine, so we work exactly like Momondo and Skyscanner.
You do take a commission, right?
Yes, we receive a commission. Every flight search engine receives the commission. That's how it works. Well, I think our website may be crashed.
No, it's just slow here. Oh, you go cheapo air.
Yeah. And you book a flight there.
But sometimes Momondo has cheaper travel agents.
There are.
Could you add those?
Agents.
How would you do
that? Yes, we definitely want to work on developing more partnerships, even the partnerships directly with the airlines. With the OTAs, it's good to watch out. If you book the flight with an OTA, to check their ratings and the reviews that they get.
Some are very strange.
Yes.
You book and then they tell you, sorry, you have to pay more.
Or do you want to avoid that? So
or do you want to cancel? You get the money back in 3 weeks. that's some strange like that. It happened to me.
You definitely have to watch out with OTAs. It's better to check the reviews before you apply.
So, this is launched?
This is launched. If you go to...
How recently did you launch?
Airwonder.com.
When did you launch?
We officially launched yesterday.
Yesterday. So, yes. And you are on a good server, like Google Cloud or something? It's not going to crash?
It's not going to crash, no. We're on AWS. It shouldn't crash.
AWS, is she work?
Maybe if we have, 50,000 users a day, that may crash.
Is there any way I can put in my favorite, airline partnership?
Preferences.
You know, like I prefer Oneworld, they give nice miles.
Again.
Nice.
But we have filters and we enable you to filter by alliance.
And how can you really, is there some kind of a trick going on? Because sometimes...
These are the airlines and the airports, you can filter by price. You can filter by layover if you want a shorter or longer layover, you can filter that.
But you don't filter by what's it called, airline groups, what do you call those?
Alliances.
Alliances.
Yes, we do.
Oh, you do?
One second.
Somewhere in there. Maybe in the airlines.
Maybe in the airlines.
Yeah. Okay.
And yes.
And can you sign up and get the notifications when the
price? Oh, really? Yes, we are actually working on user accounts, so that will be our next big release.
And what would that?
Next few days.
Next few days. That's it. Your team is really fast.
Yes, we try to be.
So what's your job right now? You're the CEO. You're here to TechCrunch Disrupt. Are you looking for? What are you looking for?
We're looking for investment. We're looking for hiring new people for marketing, for development, and for partnerships. We want to definitely develop more partnerships with airlines and OTAs. And users, of course, we want more users.
Maybe you need users and have a community inside, like behind like a forum. People share good ideas for where to go for cheap.
Yes.
And maybe like automatically they get a message. They get an email when there's like some very good suggestion
very
for them.
Deal. That would definitely be a good idea. Maybe we'll need a person for that too, because we don't have time.
That's,
so we would need a blogger.
You need one more engineer.
Yeah, or one more travel blogger to write about this, about promotions.
Cool, that's awesome. So what do you imagine next year? Are you going to be bigger than Hipmunk?
We hope.
It's possible, right?
It is possible, definitely. It has a big potential. There's a lot of people interested in combining flights to find savings or to visit a stopover. It's definitely a value for the traveler. You can visit more places and you can save money on your travels.
I spend sometimes days and days to try to find my stopovers,
uh-huh.
And you make it in one click.
Yes, we make it in one click. This particular trip, the one that goes from London...
But is that real, or when you click, sometimes the price might change because you don't have the latest prices?
No,
for sure you have the latest.
So this is real. Only sometimes you will have to maybe do the search again, because sometimes the flight can expire. Like if I pull out, for example, a link that's like a week old, then the flight may expire, so we have to reload it. But no, this is the real price. And it's really fast to do like this trip. It literally took us 2 minutes.
Nice. And there's some other couple of tricks that I heard about where people buy return but they don't take the last leg. They skip leg.
That's hidden seat. And skip leg.
Skip leg.
Yes.
Do you do skip leg function?
No. We don't have that.
You don't want to mess with that.
We just focus on something else, but if somebody wants to do that, they can go to skip leg.
Okay. Yeah. Cool. All right. That's very cool. All right. That's awesome. I'm going to use it.
All right.
So did I give you my card?
Yes, I got your card.
So if you want the title description.
I can give you my card if you want, because this is actually my co-founder's.
Oh. Can I take one of those?
Yeah, definitely.
Nice. That's going to be collectors.
Take a couple. Give it to your
friends. So how about if you want, you send me an email with the title description you like. Then I will get more views. Like everything that's inside the description will be number one. So if you say Hipmunk Killer, I think that's the way. You know, you have to be aggressive with the marketing. Say this is the new thing, and you have to say TechCrunch didn't get.
As a title,
the way to travel in the future.
that's a good one. That's
look around,
one.
Look around the world.
Uh-huh.
Check new cities.
Yeah.
It's the best thing about this planet is you can travel.
Yeah.
100
yeah,
years
yeah,
ago, it would take 10 years to travel to Istanbul.
Yeah.
Now
yeah,
it's just for free.
Yeah, exactly.
It's cheaper. Exactly. It's cheaper if you stop in Istanbul, but you might get exploded. But no, let's not talk about Istanbul. Okay.
So
you gave me your car, right?
Oh, yeah. So my co-founder just like leaves so many cars and I can't find my own.
All right. Cool. Is he American?
Yes, he is.
Engineering? Are you also engineering?
I mean, we both have like technical background, also like entrepreneurial background. But we also have like senior developers who do the developers.
Why? Why didn't you convince? Were you on stage?
Yes.
Why were you not convincing? Why didn't you get them?
I don't know. I think the investors have like a different point of view because they travel first class and they don't really care about combining.
You should them. You should have told them. Hey, we don't think you're the market. You're like snobs.
Too shy.
I should say most of the people who pay $1,200 for a ticket here also snub. It's for all the people outside and the bloggers.
Exactly.
The bloggers.
Yeah.
Okay.
You've got the luggage tag. Yeah. You got my card. So.
Thanks. It's awesome.
Yeah,
I hope it works because I'm gonna check it. I'm gonna have to use it. So.
All right.
Cool. Do you know if there's some cool other? Did you check some of them?
There's one that's really funny if you're into travel stuff.
Yeah.
There's one called Air Date.
Oh, I see that,
They're like about dating on the plane. Like, I mean, I don't know. I thought it's interesting.
It's dangerous. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And yeah, it comes from the other.
I like some of them over there, and they give free domain name. It's good.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you.
Good.
Have a good show. Have a good show. Bye bye. Hey.
Hey.
How are you? All right. That's cool. Startups. The ground. Lots of startups. Let's go in here. We've got a couple minutes. Should we get a Pepsi Max? No Pepsi Max. I'll get a water. Thank you.
There. I think there's a lot of opportunity with getting governments, cities to now think about our world, right? We make all these things independently, but how do we actually go and start solving problems that have to do with the city?
You can effectively end up holding a city to ransom, couldn't you, if they don't have any infrastructure?
Hold it for ransom? No, I mean, what we're trying to do is empower them to use the tools in order to be able to, you know, inform citizens.
Once, right? Once you've got all the citizens in that city using your app, they've got nowhere else to go.
Not really. They have their own, I mean, it's open data. So we help them create open data. We don't necessarily control the thing. We're just saying, we can make you better tools to do it. Yeah, sure, we're able to access it, but then so can anybody else. But see, it's not about control, it's not about having single proprietary access to it. It's about, we have to fix these systems out. I mean, you've got one part of the economy like us making all these great products and talking about how to make something perfect, and you've got this other part of the economy which is using antiquated software.
Let's get back to how are you going to make money?
So as I said, there's quite a few different ways we could do it. You'll see us...
Virtual advertising, you've got a big audience.
And stickers. It's going to be huge.
How are you going to get to make money?
I think we're just going to double down on the stickers. I think that's going to be the way to do it. Like, in Asia, stickers.
Is it selling the data to cities? Is that part of the idea?
That is one of them. Yeah, that's something we could do. I think it depends on, you know, what we can do that helps them improve the city.
Once you've got these cities captured, you'll be able to sell the users back to the city. You'll be able to go to businesses saying, listen, I know that 10,000 people are going to be in your area in the next 5 minutes. Do you want to make offers to these people? Kind of like a Foursquare model, in a sense. It'd be an interesting model there.
I don't know if we're that interested in local. I think if you think about transport as being a really valuable industry in itself, the local aspect is something others are doing, and it's fine. We partner with various local players like Foursquare and Yelp and the like, but I don't think that's what we do so much as the transport side is interesting to us and the data side.
I see. So that's an interesting hint. So the transport aspect of it is how you'll make money.
You'll see us doing more with transport and data.
Transport and data. Possibly ticketing, possibly taking a cut of that Uber transaction.
You know, I mean, what we have, which is really interesting and valuable, is information about mobility in the city. And you've gone through a phase, I think, in the past few years where we said we can help design mobile experiences that help make the use of the city's infrastructure better. So we like to believe that we've made better utilization off the city. For example, people are taking buses
thanks for
because
watching.
Of us that weren't taking buses.